Hello everybody, and welcome to your next Android development tutorial. Right now I'm just sitting in my car just waiting for my sister to finish track practice. So I'm like, hey, like, why not just make a tutorial? So here's the next tutorial for you guys. So let us get right into it. So this tutorial is gonna be, we're gonna be making our first Android application, and it's gonna be the simplest of all applications. So before we displayed text to the screen, so I guess we can't say this is our first application, but in this application we're just gonna be creating a button, and when we press the button it's gonna show text, and when we press it again it's gonna hide the text. So this is basically our first interactive interactive application. So let's get right into the code. Well, actually, before that, just before anything, you want to go to Windows and then AVD Manager and then launch the emulator like we've done before. Now, sometimes when you try to run your program and sometimes it says something about delegate or whatever down here, and it says something about 27% or something. If that occurs, then you want to close the emulator. Then go to Window, AVD Manager, create a new emulator. Sorry, I'm sick. Create a new emulator. You want to close Eclipse, and then you want to leave the emulator open when you close Eclipse, and you want to open up Eclipse again. And then your program should work after that. So now let's get into the actual designing, the actual code. So what you want to do is go to res and layout, then main.xml. So if you notice in main.xml I have something here called toggle button. Now you guys, that's probably new or unfamiliar to you guys, so instead of getting right into this right now, let us go into graphical layout. So in our graphical layout, as before, I said you can do things like drag and drop these options and put them onto your game screen. And with that, then you can change the settings and stuff in it in your main.xml. So right now, I've created a toggle button. I dragged and dropped it, and what I did was stretch it out to fill the screen. Right? And you can make it any size you want, up to you. Doesn't really matter. But yeah, so as you notice, for you guys, the text says off, but my text says show, right? So I'm going to be teaching you how to change that. Sorry. So we want to go back to our main.xml. Now, right here, in our toggle button, in our properties, it says Android colon text off, and it says show, and Android colon text on equals hide. So when the button is not pressed, it's not active, then it shows the text show. So when you press it, that means it's going to show content. And when the button's on, which means it's activated, then it shows the text hide. So when you press it again, it will hide the content. Now, this stuff right here should be familiar to you, or fairly familiar. The thing that should be new to you is the Android ID. Now, if you've worked with with JavaScript and HTML and all those languages, web programming languages, then this should be a piece of cake. ID is just giving it a unique ID to recognize it by, just a regular ID. So my name is an ID, okay? So say, okay, my name is Peter, and say I have one friend named Bob and next guy named Bill, okay? So my ID would be Peter, my friend's ID would be Bob, and my next friend's ID would be Bill. And then if I want, say I want Bill to walk, I would say, I would take Bill's ID, I would say ID, Bill, walk, and then Bill would walk or whatever. That's basically, I don't know if that's really a bad example, but you'll understand what I mean later. So basically, this is how we create an ID. So there's different things you can do with IDs, but to create one, you put the at symbol, you put plus, then you put ID, then you put the backslash, and then after the backslash, that's the name of the ID that you're creating. This might be a little confusing to get used to, but that's how you create an ID. So our D is called T button, which means which stands for toggle button. So after we've created that, then we actually want to go to our source code, because if you run your program right now, you will see a button on the screen and you'll click the button, but the button doesn't do anything, right? So we want to do something with the button. Now notice in our text view, I've set our text to nothing, because at first we don't want to display anything. And also for our text view, we have to create an ID for our text view as well in order to change the text that we show to show it and hide it. So I've named this ID equal to display. So if we go to our source code by going to source, then the name of our project, then our project activity, and we double click that, we're greeted with this screen right here. So there's three variables that we need to create, right? And I've created this one right here. You don't really need to create it, but this is just a string, and what this is gonna do is set the text that we want to display when we set it to show. So right now we have a string called text, which is gonna store the current text in the display. Toggle button, which is set, and we named it button, and text view is equal to display. Now, for a lot of you, sometimes, like, when you put toggle button and stuff like that, and you put button, it's gonna give you an error. And that's because it never imported the class. So, what you wanna do is that you could either import it manually by yourself, or you could just hover over it, and it will give you an option. So, let me delete this right here. So for toggle button, it doesn't show it, so you want to hover over it and you say import toggle button android.widget, and when you click that, it will automatically import for you, right? So then we have our text view and our toggle button imported, and we have the text we want to display. So right here in the public void onCreate and all this stuff right here, if you've learned about game loops and stuff like that or whatever, this is basically the game loop or the application loop. It basically continues. I wouldn't say it's a game loop, but it basically constantly checks to see what is going on in our program. So you could basically say it's a loop, but up to you. But it basically continuously checks what's going on in our program until we exit our program. And once you get into creating other activities and stuff like that, you'll see more about how this works. So right now we actually have to set our button. We've created a button and we set it's a toggle button, but we need to know what toggle button we're talking about. Say I've created three different toggle buttons. We need to know which one we're actually trying to work with, right? So what we do is that we put a button. Then we do toggle button cast. And casting, what it does is just it changes it to that type. So we're changing it to a toggle button type, and we're doing find view by ID. So a lot of you might be saying, why do we have to cast it? The reason we have to cast it is because basically, practically everything in Android is defined by views. Everything's a view. A text view is a view, toggle button's a view, a regular button is a view, a spinner's a view, etc., etc. So when we're saying find view by ID, the ID could stand for any type of view. So what we have to do is we have to cast it to the type of view that we want to store it as. So what we do is we've set toggle button, then we put find view by ID. Now notice the F in find is lowercase, the V is uppercase, the B is uppercase, and the I is uppercase. And then the way we accessed our ID is that we put r.id. And then the name of the ID that we've created. So that's just simple enough. We just put r.id.tbutton, which is the ID that we've created over here, tbutton right here. Right? So, and we do same for the display. We set it to a text view because that's the text we're displaying. Find view by ID, r.id, and the ID we gave it was display. So this is going to be working with the toggle button. This is going to be working with the text. Then with our text variable that we displayed up here, we're going to put text is equal to, we cast it to a string type, display.getText. So what we're doing, we're basically getting the current text from the text view, okay? So what we're going to do, what we have to do is that if you worked with JavaScript or something, then these stuff should be fairly familiar to you. But what we need to do is create an onClick listener. Now, what an onClick listener is, it's something that it waits, it checks to see if the button was clicked. And then if the button was clicked, then we have to do something with it. So what we're going to do, we put button.setOnClickListener, right? Now, we haven't created, we haven't really created a function in order to do something when we actually click the button, right? So what we do is we put new view, since everything's a view, dot on click listener, and then once you do that, it should create this for you. So let me show you an example. So I put button dot. Now, a good thing about Eclipse is that it shows you all the possible options. Now, it looks like there's an endless amount of options and stuff, and I think it's pretty hard for me by the end of the tutorial series to explain what every single one of them does. But a lot of them are overload functions and stuff, and they should be fairly easy to understand. And with the Android documentation site, you'll be able to figure out what they do. But I would try to walk you through what most of them do or what the important functions do by the end of the tutorials. So we're going to do is button dot, and we're going to type in set on, and then you should see on click listener. So we're going to double click that, and you're going to see something called L. Don't worry about that. I'm going to be showing you how to actually create the function name in main.xml in another tutorial, and then actually creating the function in here, and then just displaying the function name in here so you don't have to do all this messy code all over here. But what we're going to do is just set us, we created the set on click listener. We're going to do new view dot on click listener, click enter on that, and it will create all of this for us. So when this is created, then what we want to do is basically saying that when the button is pressed, what do we want to do? So we're going to do, we have two options. So we're going to put if button dot is checked, right? Which means that if the button is on or activated, then we want to change the text that is shown in the display. So what we're going to do is that if it's on, if the button's on, then we want to display the display text from the variable we created up here. So in this case, it's going to display my website if you press the button, if the button's activated. And then we just put else. So if the button's not activated, we set display, we set the text equal to nothing. So we just put that right there, the quotation marks, and then the empty quotation marks, so it won't display anything. And then at the end of here, you would have to put a semicolon there. It doesn't do by default. So you have to put a semicolon letting you know that it's the end of the function. So I'm going to delete this here because I already have it. I already have the code there. So that is basically it for your code. So if we right click right here and we go to run as Android application, we want to save everything. And if we, once it's basically installing the APK, once all that's done and we get to the screen, so just wait for it to finish. So once we get to the screen, it says show. So when we press this, it's going to show the text. We press it, it shows my website name or whichever text that you put. And then when I click it again, it hides it, and then nothing's there on the screen. So I hope you enjoy this tutorial. It's very simple, but it's very fun because you made it. It could be fun because you made it, but it's very simple. But we're on our way to making some pretty cool applications and games. So I hope you enjoy this tutorial. Thanks for watching, and bye.